The Higher Mini Split Air Conditioner 1.5 ton indoor and outdoor motherboard has been sent to us for repair. The technician who had removed both these motherboards told me that the compressor starts for 2 seconds and then stops. This is the observation of that technician. He also told me that he has tested the system for quite a while but no error code is shown on the display of the indoor motherboard. So let's check step by step what fault we get in this motherboard and make it work again. In the first step, I have powered both indoor and outdoor motherboards with electricity, by connecting them together. It has been almost 20 minutes since I passed electricity through them. It is showing an F28 error on the display. Whenever the error code is shown on the display of the indoor motherboard, the same error should be shown on the outdoor motherboard as well. The outdoor motherboard error is shown through these LED lights. 2 LED lights are installed in this motherboard. This is the second number LED, and this is the LED number 1 which is not working. The one number LED shows the error in the form of blinking. Someone had tried to repair this LED light. But right now, it is not working at all. So first I will fix this LED light. I will check whether it has gone bad while it was being repaired or if the motherboard internally is not able to make it work. After fixing this LED light, I will tell you what this F28 error code means. If both the indoor and the outdoor motherboard errors are the same, then it will be easier for me to explain. For checking this LED light, I can use 2 methods. The first method is to check it through a multimeter. I have set the multimeter on diode mode. I have placed the probes of the multimeter on the LED light. 1.947 voltage drop is shown on the multimeter. But the LED light is not glowing. Now I have changed the polarity of the probes. It is still not glowing by changing the sides of the probes. This means this LED could be bad. Now I am going to test the other LED light. I have placed the probes on the LED light. This LED light has started to glow. The voltage drop is 1.77. And this LED light is fine. Now I will use the second method to check this LED light. Using that method will help me to know whether the new LED light will work here or not. I will use the second method now to check it. I have passed electricity through it. I will check the voltages in the motherboard. 5 volts should pass here. If the 5 volts do not pass, then it means that the microcontroller is not able to turn the LED on. And if 5 volts are passing and I change this LED, then the new LED will work fine. 5 volts are passing across the LED light. The microcontroller passes electricity through the LED light. The LED itself is bad. Now I have removed the old LED light. But before installing the new LED, we should know what is the anode and the cathode of the LED light trace. The right side of the trace is the cathode, and the left side is the anode. Now I have placed the new LED here. Now I will solder it accurately. I will solder one side of the LED light. The other side of the LED has also been soldered. The LED is ready. I will pass electricity through the motherboard to check it. As I have passed electricity through it, both the LED lights are glowing. I don't have an LED red in color. That is why I installed the LED light in orange color. The indoor motherboard display is still showing an F28 error code. The LED light on the outdoor unit is now blinking. Let's count how many times the LED light is blinking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. The light is blinking 19 times. This means the indoor and outdoor motherboards are showing the same fault. This error code means that the motherboard can't detect the compressor. There could be some reasons for the compressor not working. In our case, we have not attached the compressor to the motherboard. As you saw, we were checking it, and the LED light was bad. That is why I didn't attach the compressor to it in the first place. The motherboard has been fixed now. And how I fixed it? I will explain that as well. I have turned on the indoor display with the remote. I have set the motherboard on heat mode because the room temperature of the room is 14 degrees right now. It will not work on cool mode. On cool mode, its lowest temperature setting is 16 degrees. If the temperature is 16 degrees or above that, then it will work on cool mode. The compressor has started to work. The compressor analyzer is showing that all the IGBT in the motherboard has turned on to start the compressor. The outdoor fan is also working fine. The compressor has started to speed up its RPM. As it had a complaint that the compressor stopped after 2 seconds. It is not happening now. It is further increasing its RPM. Everything is working fine. Now it has been quite a while since the system has been working. So let me tell you how I fixed this motherboard. As you know, I have changed this LED light. Other than this, these motherboards were quite dusty. I vented the dust with a blower. And after that, the system started to work properly. So why was this fault shown before when the technician was checking it? I can only give you my point of view or possible faults as I haven't seen the unit by going to the site. The compressor could be faulty in that unit. In this system, the compressor starts first and then the outdoor blower motor. If the blower motor will not work, the compressor will trip. And the indoor will start displaying the error code. I think he didn't wait for the error because the unit often runs 2 to 3 times and then shows the error code. The technician didn't complain anything about the error. He only told me that it runs for 2 seconds and stops. The third possible fault could be the electrical fault. This is also possible that he could have checked the unit on cool mode as the weather is cold nowadays. It will not work in cool mode. I will return it to the technician because both the motherboards are good. One of my viewers asked me what specification inverter compressor do you use for testing. So I will tell you all a little about this compressor. This is a brand new compressor. I put these protective caps on its discharge and suction pipes to prevent the dust from going inside it. I have covered it as I would sell it in future in good condition. This is a Reichi Universal DC compressor. You can see its specifications. I check all the brand motherboards with it. It works till the 2-ton unit motherboards. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.